As we are observing Mother's Day once again, I'd like to read a tribute to Christian mothers, something that I wrote back in Mother's Day of 1987. It's been around a long time, but I was pondering at that time because of three women in my life who served as mothers, my mother, my mother-in-law, and my wife. And I was considering the impact that they had on the lives of their children, including me, and as I watched the impact of my wife's life upon my child. And as I considered the aspects and the continual growth taking place as people aged, even as a Christian mother, I was led to write something which I've simply called A Mother's Tears. And I'd like to share that with you as we observe once again Mother's Day. A new mother caressed the warm, soft hand of her newborn child. She cried a mother's tears. Tears of joy for this new life given her. Tears of awe at this perfect creation of God. Tears of thankfulness that all had gone so well. It seemed as though the pain from giving birth had been well worth it as she gently stroked that tiny, fragile arm. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A young mother caressed the hand of her toddler child. She cried a mother's tears inside as her little one struggled first steps across the kitchen floor. And then her baby broke away from her caress and walked just 5 steps, all alone, a prophecy of things to come. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A nervous mother caressed the hand of her school-bound child. She cried the mother's tears inside as they waited for the school bus to flash its lights. Excitement welled up inside her baby's heart. Loss welled up in hers. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A proud mother caressed the hand of her graduate child. She cried inside. Such a big step in life meant separation soon for keeps. The room that had been action-packed would now be quiet, clean, vacant, except at certain times, and how she knew her heart would also fill that vacancy, that distance. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A joyful mother caressed the hand of her newlywed child. She cried, some tears outside, but most inside. How could joy and grief hold hands so tightly on such a day? Joy that now her baby would experience that special love which she herself had shared. Grief that now she must do more than share, but relinquish her exclusive claim. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A middle-aged mother caressed the hand of her new parent child. She cried a mother's tears. Tears of joy for this new life extending hers. Tears of remembrance as she recalled the first caress of her own baby long ago. Tears of expectation as she considered the spark of family love passing to a newfound generation. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A hurting mother caressed the hand of her hurting child. She cried a mother's tears. It had always hurt to see her baby hurt. Words of comfort seemed impossible to speak, for she had never lost a child. She had been spared from pain so deep, so uncontrollable. So all she did was caress her sobbing one and speak of mysteries tightly bound to God and only understood in terms of trust and how all things work together for good to those who love the Lord. But it still hurt. And she cried, deep inside she cried, while outside for her baby she kept strong. She cried as only mothers cry those special tears. A grieving mother caressed the hand of her maturing child. She cried a mother's tears. This hand she steadied and comforted so many times through life now came to steady and to comfort her. She had experienced grief and loss. Half of her had died that night. Yet within her grief, she cried tears of joy inside. She rejoiced to see how her baby had learned from mother and daddy how to care and how to cry and how to caress. She cried as only mothers cry, those special tears. An aging mother caressed the hand of her caring child. She cried a mother's tears. She remembered all too well when she once held a tiny, fragile hand to cross a street or walk an unfamiliar corridor. Now she was steadied by that same hand as she walked slowly down the tiled hallway to her room. When she became unsure or tired, that firm hand led her on with such familiar encouragement. Just a few more steps. You can do it, Mom. And she cried as only mothers cry, those special tears. A dying mother caressed the hand of her crying child. She cried a mother's tears. Tears not for herself or for her dying, but tears for her child. Tears because her dying was so difficult for this special one she loved. And yet they both knew that death was the gate to life. So their risen Lord had promised, and so it was. Death was not their sadness, their struggle. Dying was. They knew that when her eyes would close in death, her mother's tears would be forever wiped away. But she cried as only mothers cry, those special tears. A radiant mother caressed the hand of her Savior as she entered her heavenly rest. She shared a Christian mother's joy, for she knew that her baby caressed his other hand on earth. God's blessings to you.